Dear students, in this module we will cover levels and trends of fertility. Specifically, in this module we will cover aspects like global fertility trends, levels of fertility by region, means the regional differences in fertility, and then we move to fertility projections provided by the United Nations. Then we will talk about sex ratio at birth and in differentials in sex ratio at birth. Then we will also try to get understanding about net reproduction rate and the kind of situation that is prevailing in terms of net reproduction rate, that is NRR. Then we will talk about adolescent fertility, the trends and the implications. We will also try to understand the age at childbearing in various countries. Then finally, we will sum up the module learnings. At the global level, fertility patterns have changed over the last few decades. The global fertility has reached unprecedented low levels. Differences also exist in childbearing patterns across the countries as well as regions. What are the implications of changes in the fertility patterns? Population and development implications of diverse fertility patterns are as follows. Directly relevant for implementation of 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, the Sustainable Development Goals, we are calling them as. Secondly, the policy makers as well as planning managers in all the countries have to pay attention towards the changes that are taking place in fertility patterns, because the changes in fertility patterns will have implications in terms of policy and program interventions in the respective countries. Let us now examine the fertility levels in Africa and Europe. According to the UN publication, namely 2015 revision of World Population Prospects, the total fertility is 2.5 children per woman globally. Of course, there are wide ranging differentials in fertility across the regions. Africa has the highest fertility at 4.7 children per woman. Europe, on the other extreme, recorded the lowest fertility of 1.6 children per woman. Moving to Asia and Latin America, both these regions, besides Asia and Latin America and the Caribbean, these regions have recorded total fertility of 2.2 children per woman, closely followed by Oceania with 2.4 children per woman. Coming to African region, Middle and Western Africa recorded higher levels of fertility with about 5 or more children per woman. Eastern Asia and Eastern Europe, besides Southern Europe, recorded very low levels of fertility, about 1.6 children per woman. If we categorize the countries on the basis of fertility levels, the first category could be low fertility countries. About 46% of the world's population lives in countries with low levels of fertility, where women have less number of children. It was less than 2.1 children on an average per woman. The low fertility countries include all the countries of Europe and Northern America, and many of the countries from Asia, Latin America and the Caribbean. The second category could be intermediate fertility countries. 46% of the world's population lives in this category, namely the intermediate fertility countries. These countries have already experienced substantial fertility decline, with the average number of children ranging from 2.125 children per woman. The third category is high fertility countries. 8% of the world's population lives in high fertility countries, and these countries experienced only limited fertility decline over a period of time, and on an average the women have 5 or more children over the lifetime. Most of these countries are in sub-Saharan Africa. Let us now look at the fertility projections provided by the UN. At the global level, total fertility is projected to decline to about 2.4 children per woman by the year 2030, and it is projected to reach 2.2 children per woman by 2050. In Africa, fertility is projected to decline to 3.9 children per woman by 2030 and 3.1 children per woman by 2050. The fertility projections in other regions indicate fertility decline in all other regions to be more modest and may also have some small increase in Europe and Northern America. Coming to the projected pace of fertility decline in Africa, the slower projected pace of fertility decline in Africa compared to the kind of pace experienced in Asia and Latin America and Caribbean is a concern, because the slow pace of fertility decline in Africa has crucial population and development implications for the region as a whole. Let us now try to move to sex ratio at birth. The standard biological sex ratio at birth is around 104 to 106 boys per 100 girls. The sex ratios above this range indicate the use of practices and methods, including sex selective abortion, to realize strong preference for sons. That means imbalance in the sex ratio, particularly at birth, indicates practices such as sex selective abortion, which are indicating strong preference for sons, desire for sons. What are the implications of sex ratio at birth? The current sex ratios among children will have a long term impact on the population dynamics of the country, with men of marriageable age already outnumbering the women in many countries. This will be a crucial issue to be addressed. For instance, in Asian countries this is observed. In Asia, 9 out of 10 countries or the areas within Asia with highest sex ratio at birth are observed. In Asia, some of the areas have highest sex ratio at birth. Let us now move to NRR, net reproduction rate. Net reproduction rate is average number of daughters that would be born to a woman, taking into account prevailing levels of fertility, female mortality and sex ratio at birth. If n or r is 1, then each woman is exactly replacing herself with one surviving daughter. This implies that fertility is at replacement level. That means NRR 1 indicates the fertility at replacement level. When more boys than expected are born compared to the girls that are born, NRR is likely to be lower than expected NRR for the given fertility rate. And as a result of that, the long-term population growth rate will be lower. This is observed in many countries in Asia. If we look at NRR by different regions, NRR is 1.1 surviving daughters per woman, and in all the regions NRR is at or below the level except Africa. In Africa, the NRR is 1.9. That means in Africa, on an average, each mother is replacing herself with about 2 daughters. This kind of trend would lead to faster population growth. Let us now move to adolescent fertility. Adolescent birth rate is the number of births per 1000 women aged 15 to 19 years. As a result of higher adolescent birth rates, early childbearing will be more common, and one has to understand the implications of early childbearing. These include higher health risks to adolescent mothers and reduction in education and employment opportunities the girls might have had in the event of not getting married or not getting the responsibility of childbearing and child rearing. Let us look at the trends in adolescent fertility. The trends in adolescent fertility indicate downward trend across the regions. Of course, one can notice sharp differences in levels as well as trends of adolescent fertility. Africa recorded the highest adolescent birth rate with slow decline in the adolescent birth fertility. Latin America and the Caribbean also recorded higher levels of adolescent fertility. If we look at age at childbearing in Africa, Asia, Latin America and the Caribbean, in all these regions, greater decline of childbearing of women at older ages has led to decrease in mean age at childbearing. If we observe the trends in Europe and Northern America, in both these regions, fertility was already relatively low, even by 1970-75. It resulted in postponement of childbearing and increase in the mean age at childbearing. Let us now examine the age at childbearing in two specific countries, namely India and Libya. At lower levels of fertility, difference in age distribution of births is larger. India and Libya have total fertility of about 2.5 children per woman. However, more than 3/4 of the births in India are to women below 30 years of age. Precisely, 78% of the births in India are to women below 30 years of age. In case of Libya, it is 34%. That means 34% of the total births in Libya or to women below 30 years of age. Let us now look at the figure 1 that gives the TFR values by region and major area. The global fertility, as we have discussed, is about 2.5 children per woman, and there are differentials across the regions and across the major areas of the world as indicated by the figure. The figure 2 gives the total fertility and proportion of global population. The trends are available from 1970-75 to the projected values for the period 2025 and 2030. In 1970-75, the global average of children per woman was 4.5. By 1990-1995, the global average children per woman reached 3, and the figure for 2010-2015 was 2.5, and the projections indicate that by 2025-2030, the global average children per woman would be 2.4. This is according to the projections provided by United Nations. And then this also indicates that nearly half of the world lives in below replacement level fertility countries. Let us move to figure 3. It tells us about the 10 countries or areas that recorded highest total fertility in 3 different time points: 1970-75, 1990-95, and 2010-2015. For instance, during 1970-75, the top 10 countries with highest total fertility included Rwanda, Libya, Kenya, even Jordan, Algeria, and Syrian Arab Republic. In 1990-95, the top 10 countries included Ethiopia, Democratic Republic of Congo, Mali, Afghanistan, Somalia, Niger, and Yemen. In case of 2010-2015, the top 10 high fertility countries included Uganda, Angola, Mali, Somalia, and Niger. Let us now move to figure 4 that talks about the countries with lowest total fertility. That means 10 countries or areas with the lowest total fertility in the 3 different time points. In case of 1970-75, the countries with lowest fertility included Canada, Croatia, Denmark, Sweden, Switzerland, China, Luxembourg, Germany, and Finland. In 1990-95, the 10 lowest fertility countries included Portugal, Japan, Greece, Germany, Spain, China, Hong Kong. In 2010 and 2015, the 10 lowest fertility countries included Hungary, Spain, Portugal, Bosnia, Korea, Singapore, China, Hong Kong, China, Macau, SAR, and China, Taiwan province. Let us now look at figure 5 that gives the estimates of total fertility rate and the projections by region for the period 1950-2050 on the basis of UN publications. on fertility patterns for different regions like Africa, Europe, Northern America, Asia, Latin America and the Caribbean and Oceania. The projections are on the basis of high, medium and low. In case of figure 6, the saturation ratio at birth is given for Asian countries. 10 countries or areas with highest saturation ratio at birth during 2010-2015. Because the saturation ratio at birth is imbalanced in some of the countries, particularly the Asian countries. Pakistan has 108.7 boys per 100 girls. China, Taiwan, province of China, retarded 109 boys per 100 girls. Maldives, retarded 110.4 boys per 100 girls. It varies like that. China itself retarded 116 boys per 100 girls. Let us now move to adolescent birth rate by region presented in figure 7. At two different time points, 1990-95 and 2010-2015. There has been decline in adolescent fertility in most of the regions. And figure 7 gives the categories of 10 countries or areas with the lowest adolescent birth rate and the 10 countries with the highest adolescent birth rates during the time periods of 1995 and 2010 to 2015. In case of then let us move to figure 8 that gives the mean age at childbearing by different regions. There has been change in the mean age at childbearing over a period of time in almost all the regions of the world. Figure 9 gives the age-specific fertility rates. Age-specific fertility rate is more useful measure of fertility in addition to the total fertility, because age-specific fertility rate gives us the trend and pattern of fertility over different age points. Let us now move to the summary table number 1 that gives total fertility rate, net reproduction rate and adolescent fertility rate by area for the period 1970 to 2030. For the world as a whole, the TFR declined from 4.5 to 2.4. Of course, it is expected to reach 2.4 by 2025 and 2030. NRR 1.1 and adolescent birth rate is expected to decline from 75 per 1000 women of 15 to 19 years to 37 by 2025-2030. The more developed regions are expected to have a total fertility of 1.8 compared to the less developed regions figure of 2.5. In case of the least developed countries, the total fertility is expected to be 3.5. We can also see the differences between the countries on the basis of income levels, namely high income countries having the lowest fertility, whereas the low income countries recording higher levels of fertility. Same holds good for other indicators of fertility as well. So, having observed the trends in total fertility, NRR and adolescent fertility, let us summarize the discussion so far and the take home message from the discussion so far and the key learnings. We looked into the fertility trends including adolescent fertility. We also looked into the sex ratio at birth and NRR, net reproduction rate. We also looked into the age at childbearing across the countries, across the regions. The global fertility patterns have changed over a period of time, namely in the last few decades, and the fertility levels have reached unprecedented lower levels. However, there are still differences in childbearing patterns across the countries and regions. The population and development implications of fertility changes in terms of levels, in terms of patterns, need attention given the context of Sustainable Development Goals agenda. The impact of sex ratio at birth on population dynamics is an issue that needs attention. We have seen evidence in case of impact of sex ratio at birth on population dynamics. Continuing on that, the global fertility changes are noticed, and similar kind of decline in trend was observed in case of adolescent fertility also. Africa recorded the highest adolescent birth rate and also very slow decline in adolescent fertility. On the other hand, Latin America and the Caribbean also recorded higher levels of adolescent fertility. The United Nations projections indicate decline in fertility, the general fertility measured in terms of total fertility rate, as well as decline in adolescent fertility across the regions. We also looked into the NRR values. NRR 1 indicates replacement fertility, and some of the countries, particularly from the African region, recorded NRR of higher level. This kind of NRR in the African countries will have implications in terms of population growth and population structure of the countries of the region. So, this module helped us to get clear understanding about the fertility trends and fertility patterns, including adolescent fertility across the regions and countries. Thank you so much.